Very good morning all. Can everyone hear my voice? Am I audible? Please let me know. Yeah, that sounds good. I hope you all have gone through the formulas and basics of inverters also. So in this session, I found some very few new questions in your other state government exams in rectifiers and choppers, including inverters. So let me combine all the problems together. Let us solve problems in whole power electronics. Okay, let's go one by one. Question number one. In a single phase full converter, right? Just let's start. In a single phase full converter, for continuous conduction, For continuous conduction, each pair of SCR conducts for. That's the question. Right, of course they are given four options. Let me drop the options too. Option A, pi minus alpha. Option B, phi. Option C, alpha. Option D, it's pi plus alpha. That's the first question. Take your time and drop your answer. Given it is a single phase full converter, for continuous conduction, each pair of SCR conducts for. Answer please. Take your time and tell me the answer. Anyone? Option B, option A. Option A is pi minus alpha, option B is pi. What is the exact answer? Any other answer? Still you have 15 seconds. Any other answer? Option D. Oh, many of you getting option B as your answer, right? Yeah. Let me drop the answer. Listen, I hope your answer is correct. Yeah, because what they told, given it is single phase full converter, first thing, and second thing they said, for continuous conduction, key is clearly given as continuous conduction, It means, for an example, this is the complete sinusoidal input, right? And while passing it through the rectifier, what will happen? Exactly, first pair of thyristor will going for conduction at omega t equal to alpha. When the moment we are triggering the first pair of thyristor in full bridge converter, from that moment onwards, your input waveform will be reflected in the output side. But they have not talked about any type of loads at all, but they had given one thing continuously. That is, they had given one clue. The given clue is conduction is continuous. So we are giving triggering angle for the first pair of thyristor. Of course, we can say thyristor T1 and T2 will be triggered at omega t equal to alpha. Thyristor T3 and T4, this is pi, right? 180 degree. And the thyristor T3 and T4 will be triggered at pi plus alpha. It means, so this is from this moment onwards your waveform, right? So in the second half cycle, the negative waveform will be what I can say tilted, and it will be reflected in the output side up to next 180 degree. In between pi and pi plus alpha, what will happen? That is the question. Whether it is continuous or discontinuous, for that question, they had given the answer. Yes, of course, your waveform will be continuous. Okay, that is called continuous conduction. We are getting the current waveform. This is voltage. This is the voltage. Whereas here we are giving what? We are receiving the continuous output current in the output side. It could be possible by giving what? By considering the continuous angle in the output side, right? Okay, let's consider the one more thing. Question is what? They did not put any freewheeling diode here, and they have not talked about freewheeling diode. Now there are two cases. Case number one, continuous conduction without freewheeling diode. What is the time period of each pair means? Thyristor T1, T2 will conduct from alpha to pi plus alpha. And then thyristor T3, T4 will conduct from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. It will be continuous. And the second conclusion, yes, of course, this statement is true without freewheeling diode. In the question also, they did not given any freewheeling diode. Now, you can simply find out the period of each pair. What is the period here? See, to know the answer for this one, what is the total period? From here to here, the total duration is pi plus alpha. From here to here, the duration is alpha. Now I would like to know the distance between these two. So total is pi plus alpha, minus alpha will give you this distance. So our answer is going to be pi plus alpha minus alpha is going to be the conduction period of thyristor T1 under T2, that is pair of T1, T2. Such that pi plus alpha minus alpha is going to be pi. 180 degree is the correct answer. Of course, you are correct. But in the question, suppose, okay, according to the given question, answer is B, the second statement. Conducts for, okay, whereas they are given, thyristor is having continuous conduction, then what is the conduction period of each pair of thyristor with the freewheeling diode? They said in the question, they are considering freewheeling diode also. Under that situation, what will you do? If they are considering freewheeling diode, actually it will be given like this. Freewheeling diode. What is the purpose of freewheeling diode? Freewheeling diode will give continuous current in the output side, but it will skip the negative portion. It means after pi, what will happen? This negative portion will be cut out from the output. Of course, this is the period in which your freewheeling diode will conduct. Right, that is, this is the period of freewheeling diode. In this portion, freewheeling diode will conduct. Again, from pi plus alpha to 2 pi, thyristor T3, T4 will conduct. And then again, from 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha, negative portion will be removed and freewheeling diode will be in conduction. So this portion is being repeated. Now, again, here also freewheeling diode will conduct. Now what will be your answer? The answer is, now the question is, once again, find out the conduction period of each pair. What is the period? The total distance is pi from here. This is alpha. Whereas thyristor T1, T2 conducts for what? Only for this duration. Total is pi, this is alpha. So pi minus alpha will give you this distance. So what is the answer? Pi minus alpha is the correct answer. At the same time, this is for thyristor. What is the conduction period of freewheeling diode here? Freewheeling diode, it's conduct for what? It is conduct for the period of alpha. Either you can calculate this value from here or from here, wherever you want. If you calculate here, what will you get? Pi plus alpha minus pi will give you alpha. Here also you'll get the same answer. So the conduction period of freewheeling diode is alpha. So that's what I had been told you yesterday also. Most of the questions are directly taken from only two area, from the rectifiers. Am I correct or not? See there, all the questions are taken from conduction period and V naught average only. Almost 80% of the questions will be from here only. Why? Because this is the area in which we can take the question for one mark. Okay, so anyway, should try to understand this process. Under that peak inverse voltage, power factor, ripple factor, some small formulas are there. No? They are also worth for one mark. Should try to go through it. Now, I hope you are getting in which area we are getting the question often, right? Yes, let's see the next one. Let me remove this one. I hope class is going good. Okay, the second question is, a single phase full converter can operate in a single phase full converter can be operates in. They are given four options for this. Option A, first quadrant. Option B, two quadrant, that is second, wait a minute, that is two quadrants, right? Two quadrants. It's not second quadrant, two quadrants. There are two quadrants. Option C, three quadrants. Option D, four quadrant. Take your time and tell me the answer. In how many quadrant our full converters are being in the operation? I hope you all know the meaning of quadrant. Let's see. What's your answer? Option B, a two quadrant. What about others? Okay, time up. Let me try. Yeah, some others also got the answer. I'm really very happy. Listen. Actually, once again, first of all, what do we mean by quadrant? Quadrants means it is the kind of relation between voltage and current in the output portion. Of course, we are talking about power, especially. Power. In general, it is the product of what? Voltage and the current with some phase angle difference we are considering it as, but I don't want to know this one. I'm just talking about the product, voltage and the current. So in the output side, whether we are receiving the power or not, that things can be covered from the safe operating area. Safe operating area, that is called a quadrant, kind of. It's simply called a quadrant operation. Safe operating area means in which area you can operate the given system, right? So in order to calculate the power, we need two quantities. One is voltage and current. Yes, usually they are being projected in the x and y axis. In x axis, let me keep voltage. It is not necessary. I am just considering voltage in the x axis. You can also change the place. You can consider voltage in the y axis, current in the x axis. It's our wish. Again, here let me keep positive current and negative current. So here let us see the possibility of quadrant operation. Quadrant means, first of all, it's talking about energy transformation, like, of course, power transformation in between what? Source to load. At some times power is being transformed from load to source. At some times power is transformed from source to load. That cases will happen, right? Let's see. Case number one, in case of first quadrant, right? Quadrant one means in the first quadrant, voltage is positive, current also positive, right? Suppose if you are operating your system, in your operating system, voltage and current both are positive. It means you are trying to operate your system in the first quadrant. So safe operating area for that system is quadrant one. Suppose in our operating system, voltage is negative, but current is positive. Then the type of quadrant, that is the quadrant is second quadrant. We are operating our system in the second quadrant. So the safe operating area for that system is second quadrant. Then what do you mean by two quadrant? What is the difference between second quadrant and a two quadrant? Second quadrant means your system will be only being operated in the second quadrant alone. You cannot operate it in the first quadrant. Second quadrant means specifically in this quadrant. Then two quadrant means that given system can be operated in both first quadrant and the second quadrant. Then what do you mean by three quadrant? Your system might be being operated, might be in the operation in first, second and the third quadrant also. Then that is called three quadrant operation. Then four quadrant operation means your system will be in the operation in all four quadrant. That's all. So that's simply called a quadrant. Okay. So in quadrant, it simply tells us whether the power is being transmitted or not. That's kind of a safe operating area, right? Fine. In our converters, usually your full bridge converters, of course, they are talking about full bridge converter only. We have a famous person is called alpha in our SCR circuits. When the value of alpha is going to be less than 90 degree, of course, we can say 0 to 90. Under that situation, what will happen? The output voltage is positive. It means up to 90 degree, your output voltage, right? So for an example, this is going to be our input waveform. If I trigger the thyristor before 90, right? If your thyristor is being triggered before 90, then what will happen? Positive area is more, negative area is very less. Getting me? Suppose if your thyristor is being triggered after 90, then positive area is less, but negative area is more. We can draw like this. So what is the conclusion here? In order to avoid more negative area, the thing is, listen, very simple. In case if your alpha is less than 90, then you'll have more positive voltage, less negative voltage. So if you find the overall voltage, this positive plus negative will give you positive only. Because positive area is more, negative area is very less. When I am adding this total voltage in the output side, resultant also will become positive due to more positive. Whereas in the second case, negative area is more, positive area is very small. If I'll add these two value, resultant is going to be negative. Do you guys agree with me? So here, your voltage is positive, current also positive. Current never be negative. We are not reversing the direction of the current in the output side. But there is a chances of getting negative voltage in the output side. Yesterday, I had told these things. Why we are operating our alpha value as less than 90? What will happen if we'll go beyond 90? When the value of alpha will go greater than 90, of course, it can go up to 180 degree. Exactly at 90 degree, positive area and negative area are become equal. So net average value will become zero, right? So at 90 degree, what will happen? At alpha equal to 90 degree,
positive area and negative area both are equal. Positive area and negative area both are equal. If you add these two, total average value will become zero. If you go greater than 90 and up to 180 degree, what will happen? You will have more negative area, less positive area, such that output voltage is going to be negative. But at any cost, we are not reversing the direction of the current. But what we have understood here, from 0 to 90 degree, if you observe the power, power is going to be positive, because from 0 to 90, net average voltage in the output and the current both are positive, such that power also become positive. So output power positive means it is observing the power from someone. I am talking about what output person. This is output voltage, right? So this is output power. Output power, if the value of the power is positive, according to the network basics, what we saw in the quadrant, when the product of voltage and the current will become positive, it means that person is a passive element. It means that is observing the power. When the value of power is going to be negative, if the product of voltage and the current is negative, it means that person is delivering the power to someone. If you observe, in the first case, when the value of alpha is less than 90, the value of voltage is positive as well as current also positive. So the product of voltage and current in the output side will become positive. It means your load is a kind of passive element and it is absorbing the power from the source. So power is being transformed from source to load. Second case, when the value of voltage will become negative, current is positive still, but this product will become negative. It means now load is delivering some kind of power to someone. Someone means source only. So if you increase the value of alpha as greater than 90 degree, automatically power transformation will be reversed. Of course, your power is being transformed from load to source. This is what will happen after 90 degree. Anyway, still we know one thing, we can operate our thyristor in the range of what? That is, you can trigger the thyristor value of alpha from 0 to 180 degree. This could be possible. So if I maintain the value of alpha from 0 to 90, both voltage and current are positive, you are in the first quadrant. When we are going to the second part, when the value of alpha will go beyond 90 degree, automatically voltage will become negative and current will become positive, we are in the second quadrant. So the conclusion is full bridge converter can be operated in both first and second quadrant. Why I spend this many minutes here? Because we have understood many things there, right? I hope you all are getting me. This is the way you guys are being tested in your exam, because you are looking for a very small exam. I'm repeating again and again. Your question never be tough. It's all from your basics. Do you know these things or not? And I told you one more thing. Do you remember? When you are solving some 40 to 50 different questions from each and every chapter of any subject, after that you won't get any new concept, because there was no concept to take new question. Whichever the concepts that you have gone through in the first 50 question, that will come back with some new different ideas. The way they are approaching the question might be different, but concept won't be different. Same concept will be there, but you should let your brain to work there. Already we saw this kind of things in our previous questions, that is very, very important. For that you should use your brain. Fine, by practice it will come, that's not a big deal. Okay, finally, what is the answer? This is two quadrant operation, right? So this is the way you have to check the quadrant of operation in our rectifier circuits. Fine, let us see the next question. Let me remove this one. Yeah, the next question is, a 200 voltage, yeah, 200 volt DC to DC chopper. A 200 volt DC to DC chopper is turned on for 30 microseconds, I think, yes. For 30 microseconds, and it is turned off for 10 microseconds, and it's a small kind of question. Turned off for 10 microseconds. Now the question is, what is the V naught? That's all. I don't think that output is required for this question, like option. I don't want to give option. Drop your answer. I hope you all have remember, when they don't give any information about the type of the chopper that they are using, it means by default that chopper is what? Step down chopper. That is general circuit. In this question also, they had not given any type of what? Name, any kind of name for this circuit. It means you will have to approach with what? Step down chopper procedure. Tell me, what is the output? Don't take too much time. Do it fast. Let your brain to work. I'm repeating, for this kind of questions at all, don't take paper, don't do all things on the paper. This is waste of time. Roughly use your brain. How to calculate the output voltage for step down chopper? What is the formula? How to calculate the layer of duty cycle? Just let your brain to work slowly. I told you, right? Your exam is very small exam, but smartness is required. Intelligence definitely will be placed in the merit list if you are trusting in yourself. Probably. Shall we check the answer? Yeah, it's 150, right? See, let me explain. Listen. What is the formula to obtain the step down chopper output voltage? V naught is equal to alpha times of Vs. Am I correct? Yes. Where alpha is called duty cycle. Slowly let your brain just think about it. Alpha formula. What is the formula to calculate alpha? Alpha is on time divided by total time. Yes. So on time divided by total time into Vs is going to be the output voltage. What is the on time? 30 microseconds divided by what is the total time? 30 plus 10. Half time plus on time is going to be the total time. So 30 divided by 40. Of course, it is 3 by 4. 30 by 40 means 0, 0 getting cancelled. 3 by 4 into Vs. Vs is given as 200. So 3 by 4 into 200. So 200 by 4. Of course, it is 50. 50 into 3, 150. Right? Do you want calci for this? What is the answer? So output voltage V naught is equal to alpha times of Vs. What is LF alpha? That is on time divided by total time. What is the source voltage? That is 200. Of course, it was given. What is the on time? On time is 30. Microsecond is getting cancelled because in the numerator you are putting micro. Denominator also micro will be there. Micro getting cancelled out. What is the total time? 30 plus 10 will become 40. Into this is 200, right? 0, 0 getting cancelled. If I'll cancel it, I will get 50. Right? Yes. Next. 3 times of 50 will become 150 voltage. So what is the answer? 150 is the correct answer. That's all. Let us see the next one. The output of a single phase inverted bridge. Okay, single phase bridge inverter, right? The output of a single phase bridge inverter. Let me draw the waveform first. It's much better. They had given an output waveform. And its duration is clearly given as 120 degree. Yeah, that's what was given in the output side. This is V naught. Now this is the output of single phase bridge inverter, right? This is the output of what? Single phase bridge inverter. Single phase bridge inverter. Now the question is, in the output voltage, in the output voltage in the output voltage. Option A, they said fifth and seventh harmonics are absent. Fifth and seventh harmonics are absent. And option B, they said 3, 5, 7 harmonics are absent. 3, 5 and seventh harmonics are absent. Option C, 3, 9, 15th harmonics are absent. In option D, they said 3 and 7 harmonics are absent. 3 and 7th harmonics are absent. Do it fast and drop your answer. Don't take too much of time. Not necessary. First think. How to think? ஹார்மோனிக்னோடனே பயந்துடக்கூடாது. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல், இன்வெர்ட்டரில் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸ் எலிமினேஷன் அப்படிங்கிறத நம்ம எந்த இடத்துல பார்த்தோம்? அன்னெசரியாக யோசிக்கக்கூடாது. இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு ஃபார்முலாவை பார்க்கவே இல்லையே, எப்படி பண்ணுறது அப்படி யோசிக்கக்கூடாது. ஹார்மோனிக் எலிமினேஷனை பற்றி இன்வெர்ட்டரில் படிச்சிருக்கோமா இல்லையா, அதுதான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன். நார்மல் பேசிக்கெலாம் நம்ம படிச்சிருக்க மாட்டோம், பட் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸை பற்றி நம்ம படித்தோம். எந்த இடத்துல படித்தோம்? ஹார்மோனிக்ஸை எலிமினேட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு நம்ம என்ன மெத்தட் யூஸ் பண்ணோம்? தே ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் ஹார்மோனிக் எலிமினேஷன். அப்சன் மீன்ஸ் தேர் ட்ரைங் டு எலிமினேட் சம் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸ். ஸோ அப்போ எந்த இடத்துல பார்த்தோம்? ஹவு டு எலிமினேட் தி ஹார்மோனிக். வேஃபார்ம்லாம் எப்படி இருக்குது பாருங்கள். இந்த வேஃபார்ம் பார்த்தோன்னே உங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கணும் இந்த வேஃபார்ம் வந்து நம்ம எந்த இடத்துல படித்தோம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டா. லெட்ஸ் ட்ரை, ஐம் ஜஸ்ட் லுக்கிங் ஃபார் யுவர் ஆன்சர். லெட்ஸ் சி. Answer please. Take your time and drop your answer. C or B? I got two answers from your side. Check panilava, your time is over. Let's see. Okay, listen. இந்த மாதிரி வேவ் ஃபார்ம் நீங்க ஃபர்ஸ்ட் எங்க பார்த்துருப்பீங்க? Just revise. I hope you would have observed this type of waveform in pulse width modulation technique. Am I correct? In normal output, you don't get this kind of things. You can just go through it in your output waveform. We are trying to eliminate the harmonics with the help of a beautiful process is called pulse width modulation technique in our inverter side. Yes, of course, it is clearly given. Waveform le clear avanga enna solitaanga, from this we can say what? From this given data, we can clearly tell that what? They are using pulse width modulation technique, and given it is what? Single phase full bridge inverter. Of course, that is exactly correct. Right now, how will you eliminate the harmonics from here? And what it was given? Pulse width is given, right? Pulse width, this is twice of D, right? Yes. Now, from this, what we can say? Distance from the origin, from the center point, this is distance D and this is distance D. Total distance is 2D and the total pulse width is what? Twice of D. It was given as what? 120 degree. So from this, what is the value of D? I can say the value of distance is going to be, pulse width is given as 120 degree divided by 2. From this, just to pass this 2 here, what we are going to get here? From this we are going to get 60 degree. 60 has the value for D. So finally, let us come back to the formula. What is the output formula? It is summation of n is equal to hard harmonics, right? First of all, we are going to consider all hard harmonics up to infinity. What is the formula? 4vs by n pi into sin n pi by 2 into sin n times of d into sin omega t, that is n omega t, of course. This is the formula to obtain the output voltage in our what? Pulse width, single phase pulse width modulation, right? Yes, that is exactly correct. From this, now the question is what we need to talk about third harmonics, fifth harmonics, and what I can say, everything. Let us substitute what will happen here, right? The case number one, when we are substituting n is equal to 1, then what will be our output? If I will replace n equal to 1, I am going to get 4 Vs by pi, n is considered as 1, and sin pi by 2, when n will be considered as 1, sin pi by 2 will become 1 into sin, n will be replaced by 1, so sin d into sin omega t. This is fundamental output. Next, fundamental means V not 1, but it is instantaneous voltage. Don't forget, this is not RMS. This is your maximum voltage. This is your instantaneous voltage. RMS means maximum divided by root 2. You have to take it out. Fundamental RMS, right? Usually, fundamental voltage will be represented like this, right? V not 1 and matter in the fundamental. V not 1 of t, na, that is instantaneous. So it will be what? V max. This is our V max. 4 Vs by pi into sin d. And you can divide it by root 2. But remember one more thing. Remember, we are in inverter. In inverter, given it is what? In inverter, given it is RMS voltage, right? What I can say, we are trying to transform the DC voltage into AC voltage. Appa input side lende ninga edukkuradhu enna da? That is RMS voltage only. For our DC, there is no difference between RMS voltage and average voltage. Sorry, maximum voltage. Maximum and RMS are same. So whatever the voltage that will be given to you in this supply, you can directly substitute that value here. Don't divide that value by root 2. You can divide it by root 2 in case of what? Rectifiers. Don't forget that one. So while taking outside, fundamental RMS voltage means just to take it out and substitute the whatever the voltage, substitute the voltage that will be given to you from the input side. Because input is DC, not AC, to divide it by root 2 to get RMS. Maximum and RMS both are equal in DC. Anyway, come to the conclusion. Let us see this third harmonic. Let us check the third harmonic. If I'll substitute n equal to 3, then what I will get here? 4 Vs by n will be replaced by 3, right? So 3 times of pi. See, here you can replace d by its correspondent value. What is value of d? D is a 60 degree, I hope, right? So d is 60 degree. What is value of sine 60? I hope it is root 3 by 2, right? Yes. So let us consider the second case, sine 3 pi by 2 into sine 3 times of d. What is value of d once again? Value of d is going to be 60 degree, just now we saw. What is value of 3 times of 60? 180. What is the value of sine 180? I hope sine 180 is 0, right? So what is the third harmonic? If it is 0, then the total value is going to be 0. Third voltage is, third harmonic is 0? Yes. Let us check the fifth harmonic, V05. V05 means, once again, let's see, directly 4 Vs by 5 times of pi, exactly, into sine 5 times of pi by 2 into here sine 5 times of 60 degree, right? Again, you have to check these things. Now, you please tell me, 5 times of 60 is how much? 300. I hope sine 300 is not equal to 0, right? So, fifth harmonic is not equal to 0. Third harmonic will absent. But first, fundamental will be present. Fifth harmonic will present. Let us check the possibility for next one. Next hard harmonic. Anyway, we found one thing. Third harmonic won't be present. So, our option might be B, C, D. Because all this option, we have third harmonic. Let us check the other possibilities. Fifth harmonic, it is not possible. Listen, one more thing. We can eliminate the options from here. Option B cannot be the answer. Option A, first of all, cannot be the answer because fifth harmonic will present. They said fifth harmonic is absent. That is wrong. Again, in option B, they said third harmonic won't be present, but they said fifth harmonic also won't be present. Fifth harmonic will present. They said it is not present. That is wrong, right? Okay. Now, still we have two more possibilities. Let us check from this, okay? Let us take 1, 3, 5. Let us check the 7th harmonic. you know why I am spending this much, this many minutes? This formula is very important. If they are taking any question from pulse width modulation, probably for 70% accuracy will be given, that question will be taken from this formula only. They might be test you to eliminate this kind of harmonics or some output voltage formula like that, they will test you. In order to register these things into your brain, I am doing these things repeatedly, right? Let us check the seventh harmonic. What about this seventh one? 4 Vs by 7 times of pi from here, sine 7 pi by 2 into sine 7 times of 60. Right? Now, what is the value of 7 times of 60? Anyway, let me break like this. 7 times of 60. Instead of calculating that value directly, let me ask you one question. What is the value of 6 times of 60? 6 times of 60 is 360 degree. Am I correct? Yes. And then we have to consider one more 60. 1 times of 60, which is equal to 60. So totally it is how much? That is 420. I know that is equal to 420. 7 times of 60 is equal to 420. But it can be considered as 360 plus 60. 360 degree, which is equal to what? 0 degree. 360 is equal to 0. So 7 times of 60 equal to 420. 420 can be considered as 360 plus 60. Value of 360 degree can be considered as 0. So directly I can write 7 times of 60 is equal to 60 only. I hope sine 60 is not equal to 0, root 3 by 2. So 7th harmonic also will be present. It won't be 0. It won't be absent. Right? Now option D also wrong. Am I correct? They said 7th harmonic absent, but I said 7th harmonic will present. That's, I got the proof. So of course your answer is what, third option C only. Now you can check for 9th harmonic and 15th harmonic. Let me conclude. Multiples of 3rd harmonic won't be present. See there? Multiples of 3. 3 into 3, 9. Again, 3 into 5, it will be 15. Right? So multiples of 3rd harmonic won't be present. Directly we can make it as 0. That's all. In the given, for the given question, that is the answer. It is not general because it depends on the pulse width. Here, the pulse width is adjusted to 120 degree. At 120 degree, multiples of 3rd harmonics won't be present. 3, 9, 15 at all. Okay, fine. Yes, the next question, one second. The ripple content of load current, the question is the ripple content, the ripple content of load current, the ripple content of load current of a converter, of a converter, the ripple current of load current of a converter feeding RL load, feeding RL load, RL load is decided by, is decided by, is decided by option A, load resistance alone. Option B, load inductance alone. Option C, both resistance and inductance. Option D, neither resistance nor inductance. Don't take too much of time. Just drop your answer. Seconds are enough. You might be think. Read the question carefully first. The ripple content in the load current of a converter feeding RL load.
drop your answer. Be a any other answer. Any other answer? Please think and tell me the answer. See, I'm telling you one thing. Network analysis வந்து நீங்கள் கம்ப்ளீட்டாக ப்ராப்பராக அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ணிக்கிட்டீங்கன்னா எலக்ட்ரிக்கல் மிஷின்ஸ், பவர் சிஸ்டம், அனலாக் எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ், அஃப்கோர்ஸ் பவர் எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ் எல்லாமே ஈஸியாகிடும். பிகாஸ் அதோட பேஸ் தான் இது எல்லாமே. அங்கே கிளியராக இருந்தீங்கன்னா இதில் எல்லாமே கிளியர் ஆகிடும். ஃபைன் ஃபைன். ஒரு ஒரு வேஃபார்மை நம்ம அவுட்புட்டில் வரையும் போதோ யூ ஹாவ் டு திங்க். அவங்க என்ன கேட்டிருக்காங்கன்னா ஒரு வேஃபார்ம் வந்து டிஸ்டர்ட் ஆகுது, ஒரு கரண்ட் வேஃபார்ம் வந்து அவுட்புட்டில் வந்து டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட்டாக வருது. இண்டக்டிவ் லோடுக்கு ஒரு மாதிரி வருது, ரெசிஸ்டிவ் லோடுக்கு ஒரு மாதிரி வருது, சம்திங் இது மாதிரி ஒரு ஸ்டோரி இருக்குன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்களேன். கொஷனில் என்ன கேட்டிருக்காங்கன்னா ஒரு ஆர்எல் லோடு இருக்குது, அந்த லோடுக்கு வந்து நம்ம அவுட்புட்டில் வேஃபார்ம் வரைகிறோம். அது பார்த்தோம்னா இன்புட்டில் நம்ம பாஸ் பண்ண அதே மாதிரியான வேஃபார்மில் கிடையாது, அவுட்புட்டில் கரண்ட் வேஃபார்ம் வந்து டிஃப்ரெண்ட்டாக இருக்குது. அதை பார்த்துட்டு உங்ககிட்ட கொஷின் கேட்குறாங்க, அங்கே ஆர்எல் லோடு கனெக்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கேன், நீங்கள் பாஸ் பண்ண கரண்ட்டில் வந்து அவுட்புட் வேஃபார்ம் வந்து வேறு மாதிரி இருக்காது, யாரால் அந்த மாதிரி ஆயிருக்கு, ரெசிஸ்டராலையா இல்லை இண்டக்டராலையா இல்லை ஆர்எல் சர்க்கியூட்டாலையா அப்படின்னு கேட்குறாங்க. நீங்கள் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் என்ன பண்ணணும், யூ ஹவ் டு டூ சம் இன்வெஸ்டிகேஷன். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், டில் நவ் யூ ஹவ் நாட் பீன் ஃபேஸ்டு திஸ் டைப் ஆஃப் இஷ்யூ. இந்த மாதிரி கொஷின் உங்ககிட்ட யாருமே கேட்டதில்லை, பட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் யூ ஆர் அப்பேரிங் ஃபார் தட் ரைட் ஃபார் தட் கொஷின். வாட் வில் யூ டூ நவ்? ஃபர்ஸ்ட்டு திங்க் அபவுட் தி ரெசிஸ்டர். ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் மட்டும் தனியாக இருக்கும்போது இப்போ நம்ம அது வழியாக கரண்ட்டை பாஸ் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா அதோட வேஃபார்ம் எப்படி வரும்? ஒரு இண்டக்டர் மட்டும் தனியாக இருக்கும்போது, பியூர் இண்டக்டர், அது வழியாக கரண்ட்டை பாஸ் பண்ணால் அதோட வேஃபார்ம் எப்படி வரும்? இப்போ ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் ப்ளஸ் இண்டக்டர் காம்பினேஷன் வழியாக கரண்ட்டை பாஸ் பண்ணால் அதோட வேஃபார்ம் எப்படி வரும்? நவ் ஐ எம் ஜஸ்ட் ஆஸ்கிங் யூ, இண்டக்டர் மட்டும் தனியாக வச்சு நீங்கள் வரையும் போது உங்களுக்கு கிடைக்கிற வேஃபார்மும், ரெசிஸ்டர் ப்ளஸ் இண்டக்டர் காம்பினேஷன் இருக்கும்போது உங்களுக்கு கிடைக்கிற வேஃபார்மும் ஒரே மாதிரி இருக்குமா? Someone said that your answer is B. B means you are telling that output waveform is not affected by the resistor, only inductor will take the responsibility for the ripple in inductor current, right? Sorry, in the output current. As per your answer, I'm just asking you, you just think, let your brain to think, right? See, don't hesitate to give your answer. It is not the correct-ஆ தப்பா அப்படிங்கிறது இங்கே பிரச்சனை கிடையாது. அதுக்கப்புறம் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணும், you should think, okay. இஃப் இண்டக்டர் மட்டும் இருந்தால் நமக்கு வேஃபார்ம் எப்படி வரும், ரெசிஸ்டர் மட்டும் வந்தால், ரெண்டு பேரையும் காம்பினேஷன் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா என்ன நடக்கும் ஆக்சுவலாக? வெதர் யுவர் வேஃபார்ம் வில் சேஞ்ச் ஆர் நாட், யூ ஜஸ்ட் கன்சிடர் இட். லிசன், ரெசிஸ்டர் மட்டும் நீங்கள் தனியாக வச்சிங்கன்னா இன்புட்டில் நீங்கள் என்ன வேஃபார்ம் பாஸ் பண்ணுறீங்களோ அது அப்படியே அவுட்புட்டில் வந்துடும். வேரியஸ் இஃப் யூ ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் இண்டக்டரை பற்றி நம்ம பேசணும் அப்படின்னா, இண்டக்டர் அப்படிங்கிறது இட்ஸ் அ கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஸ்டோரேஜ் எலிமெண்ட், இட் வில் டேக் சம் டைம் to charge and discharge at all. But if it is the pure inductor, then what will happen? You just think about it. If it is a pure inductor, then what will happen? There is no point of discussing about time constant. Just think, in the basic network analysis, we know the basic fundamental properties of RL circuit. It does not matter what kind of source that was being connected with your inductor. Inductor never accepts sudden changes. It might be your AC or DC, does not matter here. But in AC, that effect is not significant. That's why we are not considering it. But DC, this effect is significant. That's why we are analyzing it fully. Anyway, the conclusion is what? Inductor never accepts the sudden changes. Of course, capacitor also. So according to that point of view, there is some kind of story is there. Suppose inductor will be separately being placed at some places, then you no need to talk about the time constant parameter because there is no resistor with you in order to discharge the energy. Suppose if your resistor is being connected with your inductor, then what will happen? Some amount of energy will be stored across the inductor, some amount of energy will be dissipated across the resistor. Under that situation, you will also have time constant. That time will decide the nature of the current. At what time period your current will be exponential, because in inductor, you have to check, right? There is two part, one is exponential part and another one is what? Steady state. Exponential means transient part. That transient part will be decided by resistor. Because it will be decided by time constant, tau is equal to L by R. Based on the value of the R, you can predict the time constant. Time constant only will tell you
what will be the time taken by that inductor to charge to the maximum value or to discharge to the minimum value. So without resistor, if you are talking about the inductor, story will be different. If you are talking about any person with the resistor, that story will be different. It might be capacitor with resistor or it might be inductor with resistor. So the finalized conclusion is the output waveform, right? If you have resistor, then resistor is the only person will take responsibility for the current. But there is no ripple. If you have only resistor, resistor won't distort the waveform because resistor will accept the immediate changes. Whatever the things that you are giving, it will just buy it from you and it will give it to someone, like to the air somewhere. But it won't distort the waveform. Okay, the nature of the thing. Now, you get any information, like resistor, you get any information, you can pass it away. So, various inductor, of course, it will get the information from someone, but not in the same way of we are giving. It will change there, it will take some time to accept the changes, and then finally it will give. But it will take some time for that. So, what is the conclusion here? Appa inductor la ripple varum, current porutha irukum. Thani thaniya paathina resistor la ripple irukadhu, inductor la ripple irukum. If I group them together, now what will happen? Time constant will fall in place, na tau is equal to L by R. Based on the value of resistance, time constant will be predicted. Based on the value of time constant, current will change. So what is the conclusion? Ripple in inductor will be decided by both resistor and inductor. It is not only inductor. You should think. That's what I am telling. For this, is there any new book should be required for that? Already we know all these things. We know how to be, how to learn, how to apply it. So what is the finalized conclusion? If you have R and C or R and L, then you have to consider the effect of R also, because time constant will fall in place. Okay. What is the correct answer? My answer is option C, not B. Let's go ahead with the next question. One second. In a two-pulse bridge converter, in a two-pulse bridge converter, in a two pulse bridge converter with the freewheeling diode, nice question, right? With the freewheeling diode, with the freewheeling diode, the width of the diode current pulse over one cycle, the width of the diode current pulse over one cycle means 360 degree, over one cycle is, I hope you don't want option for this. Anyway, let me give you the option. Option A, pi plus alpha. Option B, phi minus alpha. Option C, phi. Option D, none of the above. Can you guess it? நம்ம கொஞ்ச நேரத்துக்கு முன்னாடி இதை பத்தி பேசியிருந்தோம். நம்ம அதுக்கான ஆன்சர்லாம் நான் கொடுத்துட்டேன் ஆல்ரெடி. இதை க்வெஸ்சனுக்கு வேற மாதிரி பார்த்தோம். நம்ம இதை பத்தி பேசல, க்வெஸ்சன்ல வேற கேட்டிருந்தாங்க, பட் நான் இதை பத்தி பேசினேன். ஃப்ரீலிங் டயட் ஃபுல் கன்வெர்டரில் இருந்தால் என்ன ஆகும்னு நான் சொல்லியிருந்தேன்ல, இப்போ அதை தான் க்வெஸ்சனாகவே கேட்டிருக்காங்க. டோன்ட் டேக் டூ மச் ஆஃப் டைம். ஒன் சைக்கிள் மீன்ஸ் ஃபார் 360 degree. வாட் இஸ் தி கண்டக்ஷன் பீரியட் ஆஃப் டயோட் மீன்ஸ் தேர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் ஃப்ரீவீலிங் டயோட். டோன்ட் திங்க் தர் இஸ் சம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் அதர் டயோட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் இன் சைட் தி சர்க்யூட். தட் இஸ் பிரிட்ஜ் ரெக்டிஃபயர். இட் மீன்ஸ் அதுக்குள்ளே இருக்கிறது தான் தைரிஸ்டர் சம்திங். அது டயோடோட, அதை பற்றி அவங்க பேசலை. ஃப்ரீவிலிங் டயோட பீரியடை பற்றி பேசிட்டு இருக்காங்க. தி வித் ஆஃப் தி டயோட் கரண்ட் பல்ஸ் ஓவர் தி ஒன் கம்ப்ளீட் சைக்கிள். ட்ராப் யுவர் ஆன்சர் ப்ளீஸ்.
What is the answer? How many of you tried yet? Yeah, your time is over. Listen, let me try to solve. Someone said option D, someone said option A. Let's check. Okay, fine. இப்போதான் நம்ம கொஞ்ச நேரத்துக்கு முன்னாடி வேவ் ஃபார்ம் வரைஞ்சோம். சி லிசன், திஸ் இஸ் இன்புட் வேவ் ஃபார்ம். நவ் வித்தவுட் ஃப்ரீவில்லிங் டயோட் லெட் மீ ட்ரிகர் தி ஃபுல் பிரிட்ஜ் ரெக்டிஃபயர் அட் ஒமேகா டி ஈக்குவல் டு ஆல்ஃபா. ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன்? இன்புட் வில் பி ரிஃப்ளெக்டட் இன் தி அவுட்புட் சைடு. அஃப்கோர்ஸ் இட் வில் பி கண்டினியூஸ் அன்டில் தி அரைவல் ஆஃப் நெக்ஸ்ட். இட் டிபெண்ட்ஸ் ஆன் கண்டினியூஸ் ஆர் டிஸ்கண்டினியூஸ் கண்டக்ஷன். லெட் அஸ் அஸ்யூம் யுவர் கண்டக்ஷன் இஸ் கண்டினியூஸ். Conduction is continuous means your cycle is continuous its conduction until the arrival of next pulse pi plus alpha, and then again we are triggering there is a T3 and a T4. Again the next waveform will be projected in the output, it will be continuous. Yes, up to what? 2 pi plus alpha. This is without freewheeling diode. Of course this action will be continuous without freewheeling diode. Suppose if I will consider the effect of freewheeling diode also, what will happen here? Just think about it. If I will put a freewheeling diode, then what will happen? Freewheeling diode will remove the what? Negative portion. This is the portion where your freewheeling diode will be in conduction at a negative voltage. So automatically what will happen? Freewheeling diode will short circuit your output port. So current flow will be there, but voltage won't be there. So if you draw the waveform for the output voltage with the freewheeling diode, negative portion will gone because that is the area in which your freewheeling diode will be in conduction. Again negative portion will gone. So here freewheeling diode will conduct, here freewheeling diode will conduct, here in the positive upcycle thyristor will conduct, T1 T2 will conduct, T3 T4 will conduct, and so on. Now this is 2 pi, right? What is the question? In a 2 pulse bridge converter with a freewheeling diode, the width of the diode, they are talking about freewheeling diode, the width of the diode current pulse, that is current means through the diode we are circulating current only over one cycle. The question is over one cycle means this is one complete cycle 360 degree. What is the conduction period of the freewheeling diode? Freewheeling diode will conduct in the negative portion of the voltage. So here one alpha, one more alpha, this is the conduction period over one complete cycle. So the total time period, conduction period of the freewheeling diode, which is what? Twice of alpha. I told you I had given the answer for this question already. நம்ம முன்னாடி பார்த்தோம்ல இதே வேஃபார்ம் நான் அங்கேயும் வரைஞ்சு காமிச்சேன். வித் ஃப்ரீவிலிங் டயோட், வித்வுட் ஃப்ரீவிலிங் டயோட் வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன்? நாங்கள் சொல்லியிருந்தேன் ஐ புட் ஆல்ஃபா ஒன்லி இன் தட் கேஸ். வை? பிகாஸ் ஐ வாஸ் கன்சிடரிங் ஒன்லி ஒன் பல்ஸ். பட் கொஸ்டின்ல என்ன கேட்டிருக்காங்க? கன்சிடர் ஒன் கம்ப்ளீட் சைக்கிள் அண்ட் டெல் மீ தி ஆன்சர். ஸோ ஒன் கம்ப்ளீட் சைக்கிள் மீன்ஸ் டூ ஆல்ஃபா வில் கம். ஸோ தட் இஸ் தி டோட்டல் கண்டக்ஷன் பீரியட் ஆஃப் ஃப்ரீவீலிங் டயோடு. ஸோ வாட் இஸ் தி ஆன்சர்? நன். Do you know one more thing? In your question, in option D, the given answer is twice of alpha only. I thought that you guessed the answer. That's why I had removed this one and I put none. Anyway, this is the answer. Okay, let's see the next question. See, this is one of the beautiful questions. Same model I have seen in this year gate also. One more question. That question was being repeated. Let me drop that question first. This question already, it was being asked in the state government of Andhra. Same question was being repeated in this year gate also. Actually, the given is, they had given a diagram like this. Simple circuit with the output resistance is 10 ohm and this is, they are not given these, yeah, this value is not known, but they said this is chopper circuit. That's all. Now the question is, what is the effective input resistance? Delta is given as 0.2, in bracket they are given this one. What is the effective input resistance? Yes, they are given four options: 10 ohm, 50 ohm,
20 ohm, 5 ohm.
Take your time and tell me the answer. It's not a very big question. First, let me conclude. It will take two steps, you will get the answer. This year in GATE also, if you check the question paper, there was a question, find out the input resistance of a chopper. I forget that circuit actually, but this question was there. Input voltage is not known, ma'am. Avladam, this is the given data. You just think. நம்ம எல்லாரும் கன்ஃபியூஸ் ஆகும், கண்டிப்பாக இந்த கொஸ்டின் அட்டன் பண்ண மாட்டோம் அப்படிங்கிறது அவங்களுக்கு தெரியும். ஏன்னா நிறைய பேருக்கு இது புதுசான மாடல் மாதிரி தெரியும். பட் லைட் ஸ்மால் இன்டெலிஜென்ஸ், ரைட், ஏ லிட்டில் பிட் ஆஃப் இன்டெலிஜென்ஸ் ஷுட் பி ரெக்வயர்ட் ஃபார் திஸ். ஏன்னா ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் கேல்குலேட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு நம்ம நெட்வொர்க்கில் என்ன ப்ரொசீஜரை வந்து நீங்கள் யூஸ் பண்ணுறீங்களோ, தட்ஸ் எனஃப். தட் இஸ் திஸ் ஒன் ஓன்லி ப்ரொசீஜர் தட் வி ஆர் யூஸிங் இன் என்டையர் எலக்ட்ரிக்கல் என்ஜினியரிங் to calculate the value of resistance. Let me give you a small clue. How will you calculate the R Thevenin? I think that clue is enough. RTH. Thevenin resistance eppadi find pannuvinga? That is the general procedure. Our derive panna theorem dhaan general for all electrical engineering circuits to find out the resistance. அதனால் அவங்க இந்த சர்க்கியூட்ஸ்க்கும் அப்படி கேட்டிருக்காங்க. பட் நம்ம அப்படி யோசிக்க மாட்டோன்றது அவங்களுக்கு தெரியும். Very few. I am not blaming everyone. You just from this moment onwards get the idea how to apply Thevenin here. Should think. Two port network la neenga calculate panuvingala same procedure ella edathilume namba generally use pandra da inge use panna porom. But you just think and tell me the answer. VDC not required for this question. I hope as per my solution. Answer please. Did anyone got the answer? 10 ohm? Any other idea? No, your time is over. Let me drop the answer. Listen. First of all, what kind of circuit it is? I hope it's a step-down chopper. Am I correct? Because what is the purpose of keeping inductor and a capacitor at all? They are taking some filter action in our circuit. This is general step-down chopper. It means in chopper circuit, we will have two things. One is our input voltage. That is continuous, but in the output voltage we are doing some kind of chopping. It means, for an example, I am allowing this input cycle for a particular time period. Let me call this source voltage is Vs. Just think, slowly observe. I am closing this switch for a time period is called T on. So from 0 to T on we are closing the circuit. Automatically input will be reflected in the output. Am I correct? Yes. So the same voltage will be dropped across the resistor. There was no any other person in the circuit. So when I am closing the switch, automatically this voltage will be dropped across the resistor. I have only one person who is going to consume the voltage from the supply. So this total voltage will be dropped across the resistor. Right? But only for a particular time period, that is 0 to T on. Next, what will happen? Again, I am opening the chopper, that is this switch. If it is open for a particular time period, that is called off time period. Right, this is a total time. This time period is called off time period. Then what will happen? Again, same cycle is being repeated. On time, off time, on time, off time. It is keep on going. Now, in order to obtain the V naught average, what is the formula here? How will you calculate the V naught average? Average only means area by time period. Now, catch the area. Time period means total time period. Of course, the total time is T. Total time period is T. What about the area? To calculate the area, I have to consider two portions. One is on time, another one is off time. In off time, area is zero. Whereas in on time, what is the area? On time area. This is on time, output waveform is look like a rectangular. What is the formula to calculate the area of rectangular? Area means we have to consider width into height. What is the width? Width is T on. Height is Vs. So that is Vs into T on. So I can say V naught average equal to T on by T is nothing but alpha or delta something duty cycle into Vs. Now you please tell me what kind of output it is. It is the output of buck converter. So given it is buck converter only, that is step down chopper. Yes sir, that is exactly correct. Okay, these things that are I am accepting. Now the question is what? Input resistance is what? Now in our Thevenin circuits, whenever we have some kind of circuits and whenever you are trying to drive the input impedance or output impedance, calculate பண்ணும்போது நம்ம யூஷுவலா என்ன பண்ணுவோம், அகார்டிங் டு தெவனன் ப்ரொசீஜர், இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு கால்குலேட் தி இன்புட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் ஹியர், இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் கன்சிடரிங் தி டோட்டல் சர்க்யூட், யூ ஜஸ்ட் ரெக்வஸ்டட் டு டேக் தி ரேஷியோ பிட்வீன் ஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு வி பை ஐ. அகார்டிங் டு ஓம்ஸ் லா, இஃப் யூ பிரிங் தி ரிலேஷன் பிட்வீன் தி சோர்ஸ் வோல்டேஜ் அண்ட் சோர்ஸ் கரண்ட், தட் வில் கிவ் யூ தி இன்புட் இம்பிடன்ஸ் ஆர் நாட். இன் தெவனன் தியரம் வாட் வில் யூ டூ? யூ ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தி ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் அக்ராஸ் தி லோட் ஓன்லினா. ஸோ ஹவ் வில் யூ ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தி லோட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ்? To find out the load resistance, usually what we are doing, we are trying to take the ratio between VDC and IDC or not. This VDC and IDC means it's a kind of voltage and a current that we are driving from the output. So what is the conclusion? Same procedure that I am applying here also or not? Yes, of course. So total resistance means it's simply there are two ways. One is you have to completely reduce the entire circuit. But in that case, there is a problem. The problem is, if your entire circuit is contained only resistance, without any switch or any other things, inductor, capacitor, combo, without anything, if you have purely resistive network, you can simply reduce them towards your port, you will get the total resistance. That is the one and only circuit, there you can get the equal resistance in that way. That way means, if your circuit is contained only resistor from the source, if your circuit will contain only resistance from the load, then you can simply reduce the circuit to get the total resistance. Suppose if your circuit will be the combination of resistance plus inductance or combination of capacitor or switches or some other kind of circuits, under that situation, you'll have to go with the second model of Thevenin's theorem. In Thevenin's, we saw there are three models. Model number one. When there is no dependent source in your circuit, directly you are asked to deactivate all independent sources, reduce the circuit from the output port, find the total RTH. That is one model. But when your circuit is having dependent source also, what will be the procedure? We are looking for a new model, new methods. In that new methods, what we are trying to do? We are trying to get the answer by driving the circuit with some external voltage and current. That's what I am doing here, because my circuit, it's not only containing resistor, there is some kind of other mechanism is there, that is switching. It means this resistance cannot be your input resistance. In between, we have some switching mechanism. If this resistance is permanently connected with your input source, your answer is 10 ohm only. If you are observing this circuit from here, you please tell me whether this resistance is permanently connected with your source or not. No, it is not, sir. Why? Because there is some kind of switch, sir. Only for a particular time period it will be connected, for a particular time period it will be disconnected, sir. So this one cannot be your effective input resistance. Of course, it is the effective output resistance. Why? Because it is permanently connected in the output port. So in the output, it is effective output resistance. But from the input, this is not the effective input resistance. So our target is we have to bring the relation between this input and input voltage and the input current. From this output port, we have to do some transformation. Let's see how to do this one. See, there are no very big things to learn. By practice, automatically these things will fall in place. தவனன்ஸ் தேரத்தில் நீங்கள் என்ன அப்ளை பண்ணீங்களோ சேம் திங் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுவோம் யூஷுவலாக தவனன்ஸ் தேரத்தில் நம்ம அந்த சோர்சஸ்லாம் கனெக்ட் பண்ணதுக்கப்புறம் அதுக்கு நேரர் பாயிண்டில் நோடல் அப்ளை பண்ணுவோம் அண்ட் விர் ட்ரைங் டு பிரிங் தி ரிலேஷன் பிட்வீன் விடிசிக்கும் ஐடிசிக்கும் நோடல ரிலேஷன் வர மாதிரி அந்த என்டையர் பேராமீட்டர்ஸையும் நம்ம கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணுவோம். தட்ஸ் ஆல் ரைட். ஸோ இங்கேயே நம்ம அதை தான் பண்ண போகிறோம். லெட் மீ ட்ரை டு டூ திஸ் ஒன். ஐ அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் ஒன் திங் ஹியர், தி அவுட்புட் வோல்டேஜ் வி நாட் இஸ் டெல் டைம்ஸ் ஆஃப் இன்புட் வோல்டேஜ். அண்ட் தி நெக்ஸ்ட் திங்க் இஸ், இஃப் யூ அப்சர்வ் வென் எவர் யுவர் சர்க்யூட் இஸ் க்ளோஸ்ட், கரண்ட் வில் ஃப்ளோ. Close the circuit. If your circuit is open, current won't flow. I understood one thing here. There is no difference between input current and output current. But voltage will be different. voltage will be different, but there is no difference between input current and output current. Why, sir? Why? Because if the switch is open, input current is zero, at the same time output current also zero. If the switch is closed, both input current and output current are same, na, series circuit. Whereas for voltage, it is not the case. If switch is closed, output voltage will be there, input voltage also will be there. If switch is open, output voltage will be zero, input voltage will be not equal to zero, still it is present. So for voltage, your case will be different. But for current, switch is open, both are zero. Switch is closed, both are not equal to zero with the same value. So input and output current both are same. So the second statement is, source current and output current both are same. First, now we have to bring the relation between. அப்போ நம்ம என்ன புரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டோம் இங்கே? இங்கே எனக்கு டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் என்ன வந்திருக்குன்னா, சோர்ஸ் வோல்டேஜுக்கும் அவுட்புட் வோல்டேஜுக்கும் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் வந்திருக்கு, பட் சோர்ஸ் கரண்ட்டுக்கு தெர் இஸ் நோ டிஃப்ரென்ஸ். ஃபார் தி சோர்ஸ் கரண்ட் தெர் இஸ் நோ பிக் டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் தட் ஐ ஃபவுண்ட் ஹியர், ரைட்? ஸோ லெட் அஸ் சி வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன் ஹியர். நவ் வாட் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டூ, தி திங்க் இஸ், ஐ நோ வாட் ஐ கேன் சே, வி கேன் ரெடியூஸ் திஸ் ஈக்வேஷன் இன் டூ வே. First one is, I have to transform this value from output to input. Let us see. Instead of considering IS, I can consider I naught. Right? And then VS by, instead of considering I naught, I can consider V naught by R according to Ohm's law. And then instead of considering R will lies in the numerator, instead of considering V naught, I can consider delta times of VS, because we know the relation. So VS, VS getting cancelled, RS by delta is going to be your answer. This is one way. Just I am bringing the relation between input and output. I am doing transformation, right? This is the one and only procedure. There are no more things. இல்லனா நீங்க வேற என்ன பண்ணலாம் அப்படினா, சோர்ஸ் கரண்ட் அப்படியே வச்சிட்டு அவுட் சோர்ஸ் வோல்டேஜ் வந்து ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம் பண்ணலாம். லெட்ஸ் see anyway. இங்க ஆன்சர் என்ன வருதுன்னு பார்த்தலாமா? ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வேல்யூ so much, that is 10 by 0.2. 0.2, I think this is 50 ohm, right? Am I correct? 100 by 2, yeah, that is 50 ohm only. Yes, option B. Now what is the second way? Instead of touching the source current, we can touch the source voltage, I think. Let's see. Let's try in that way also. This is the famous model. Let's see. For source voltage, what we can write? Source voltage can be written as output voltage V naught by del. Somehow we have to bring the relation between input and output parameter such that resistance will be transformed to the input side. V naught by del divided by IS. Now let us touch. Now what can I do now? IS can be directly considered as I naught, output current. Now next, what I can say from this simple step, listen, what we know according to Ohm's law, R is equal to V by I. Yes. So here what I can say, R, this is output resistance. Output resistance equal to output voltage divided by output current. So output voltage divided by output current can be directly replaced by output resistance. That is also correct. So what will you get? Same 50 ohm. There is no changes. So it's your way of thinking. உங்களுக்கு மைண்ட்ல என்ன தோணுதோ just you can apply it to get the answer. That's all. So what is the correct answer? 50 ohm. நான் என்ன சொன்னேன், ஒரு விஷயம் கிளியரா மைண்ட் ரெஜிஸ்டர் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. When your circuit will have only resistors, then அப்படியே சர்க்கியூட்டை ரெடியூஸ் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. நீங்கள் எந்த இடத்துலேருந்து கேல்குலேட் பண்ண போறீங்களோ அந்த பாயிண்ட்டுக்கு நீங்கள் சர்க்கியூட்ஸ் ரெடியூஸ் பண்ணீங்கன்னா யூல் கெட் தி நெட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். Suppose if your circuit will have some other combination, like some dependent sources, or like what I can say, some switches will be there, inductance and a capacitor with the resistor. If you find those kind of combinations, reduce the circuit fully from the supply. Should try to get the relation between source voltage and source current in order to find out the resistance alone. Clear? I hope you are getting me. See, one thing did you observe? Did I took any question from critical inductance, critical capacitance, ripple in inductor current, ripple in capacitor voltage? Did I done anything like that till now? No. Why? Because there was no question. It does not mean that you can't expect the question from that area. Numerical problems cannot be solved for one mark. That is worth of 2 mark. Okay, so directly you might be tested for those formulas. They might give 4 formulas. Find the formula for ripple current in for buck boost converter or buck converter, boost converter. For that, formulas are mandatory. But in numerical problem wise, questions are pretty simple. one step, two step, you will get the answer. That is worth of 1 mark. Actually, always 1 mark question ku eppadi kodupanga appadina questions edukkumbodhu brain ku work kodukapanga. Mostly brain ku dhaan work kodupanga. Ena 1 mark appadina neenga evlo smart ah think pandreenga adukku dhaan 1 mark. 2 mark question pogumbodhu smart ah think panadhukku appuram koncham adu eppadi proper ah neenga apply pandreengendra test pandradhu dhaan 2 mark. Avladhaan, there are no more things. That's why I am repeatedly forcing you to use your brain. You will be placed in the merit list. There is no doubts. Clear understand pantingna, even you can get above 90 also. That's not a very big deal. Fine. Let us see the next one. Okay. A pulse width modulation, that is PWM switching scheme, is used with a 3-phase inverter. Yeah, this is a very good question actually. I would like to give this one. Listen. The pulse width modulation switching scheme is used with a 3-phase inverter two. They are given 4 options for that. In option A, they said to reduce the lower order harmonics and to increase the higher order harmonics. I am talking about 3-phase inverter, don't forget. Option B, minimize the load on DC side. Option C, increase the life of battery. Option D, reduce the total harmonic distortion and with the modest filtering. Reduce the THD with the modest filtering. I hope you all know the answer. Drop the answer. Someone had given the answer. Is there any other options? Listen, I am repeating once again. I hope every one of you know the answer for one thing. Pulse width modulation technique வந்து நம்ம யூஸ் பண்றதோட மெயின் பர்பஸ் என்ன அப்படின்னா, ஆக்சுவலாக யூஸ்வலாக நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுவோம் அப்படின்னா, லோயர் ஆர்டர் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸை எலிமினேட் பண்ணிடுவோம், ஹையர் ஆர்டர் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸை இன்க்ரீஸ் பண்ணி விட்டுருவாங்க. ஆக்சுவலி இட் டஸ் நாட் மீன் தட் வி ஆர் இன்க்ரீசிங் தி ஹையர் ஆர்டர் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸ். யூ ஹவ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வி ஆர் ரிஜெக்டிங் தி லோயர் ஆர்டர் ஹார்மோனிக்ஸ். தட் இஸ் தி கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர் ஃபார் தட். அஃப்கோர்ஸ் இன் தட் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ ஐ ஹோப் மெனி ஆஃப் யூ வில் கிவ் தி ப்ரையாரிட்டி ஃபார் ஆப்ஷன் ஏ. பட் லெட் மீ டெல் யூ ஒன் திங், this is in the pulse width modulation scheme point of view, we are eliminating or we are rejecting the lower order harmonics. That's correct, right? Your answer is correct. But the question is, in 3-phase inverter circuits, 3-phase means bulk power transmission, in that case, for which case, that is in which scheme, that is what is the purpose of giving priority for this pulse width modulation scheme? That is the question. Let me tell you the answer. In the practical system, this is not the correct scenario for that. Actually, we are trying to reduce the total harmonic distortion, total value, right? So with the modern filter circuits, right? Actually, what we are trying to do anyway, ninga anga lower order harmonics vandu reduce panumbodhu enna aadum appadina automatically THD will be reduced, right? So our target is 3-phase inverter sodina, in bulk power transmission we are trying to reduce the net harmonic. We are not in trying to increase the higher order harmonics, or this is not the process, kind of process that we are doing. We are trying to keep our attention with the THD. I don't know how many of you done the experiment in power electronic circuits, right? அதில் பண்ணவங்களுக்கு தெரியும், தெர் இஸ் அ சர்க்யூட் இஸ் கால்ட் மல்டி ஸ்டெப் இன்வெர்டர், தட் இஸ் மல்டி லெவல் இன்வெர்டர். இஃப் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் ஃபார் ஹை லெவல், நம்பர் ஆஃப் லெவல்ஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ் பண்ண ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக THD வந்து டிக்ரீஸ் ஆகும். தட் இஸ் தி ப்ராஜெக்ட் தட் ஆல்சோ ஐ ஹவ் டன், ரைட்? So we are trying to reduce the THD in three phase inverters, right? So our main target is option D. Don't forget, that's why I took this question. Okay, the next question is, the ripple factor of a full wave rectifier circuit compared to the half wave rectifier. Ripple factor. I hope you all know the formula to calculate ripple factor. Question is, ripple factor of full wave rectifier compared to half wave rectifier. That is the question. Compared to half wave rectifier. For that, they are given four options. Option A, they said full wave rectifier is half of ripple factor of half wave rectifier. Ripple factor of full wave rectifier is half of the ripple factor of half wave rectifier. In option B, they said less than half of the half wave rectifier. Option C, they said equal to half of the half wave rectifier. Wait, what they are trying to mean? Listen, this is not off actually. Equal to half wave rectifier, that's all. In option D, more than half wave rectifier. Actually, more than half that of the half wave rectifier. That's all. So, what is the question here? They are talking about ripple factor, right? First of all, let me define the formula. You please bring the answer. Ripple factor formula enna? Voltage ripple factor. I am writing the answer for voltage ripple factor. Fundamental RMS voltage square minus total output RMS square divided by total output voltage square, right? We should keep them under root. Anyway, I'm just revising these things. This is not required for our quiz. You have to think logically and tell me the answer. Don't take too much of time. Ripple, voltage ripple, enna agum? Is there anyone given the answer? Option A was, sir. Option A, which is half of half a rectifier. Do you know the reason exactly? Ripple factor. I'm talking about ripple factor. I'm not talking about the kind of relation between half a rectifier and a full rectifier. You have to think slowly, a little bit patient, okay? Tell me the answer. Okay, first of all, I'm just asking you a kind of relation. The ripple factor, right? LRM, everyone, I'm just expecting the answer from everyone. Listen, I would like to know the relation between ripple factor and a harmonic. If you know the answer for my question, you definitely will give the answer for this one. Ripple factor increase acha appadina harmonic enna agum? That's what my question. Can anyone please tell me? Like, my question is whether the harmonic will increase or decrease. That's what my question. Ripple factor increase ana harmonic enna agum? Please drop your answer in the comment section. If you know the answer for this one, you will know the answer for this one also. Tell me your answer. I'm just asking you, if I will increase the ripple factor, then what about your harmonic? Harmonic enna agum mattum solunga. I hope board is clear, right? Yeah, that's pretty good. What will be your answer?
Nova. Okay, let me tell you one thing. Listen. Harmonic will increase as a no. This is wrong. What is this? Ripple factor increases in the sense ripple is decreased. Voltage ripple, right? So ripple factor and ripple in voltage both are inversely proportional. First, okay. Just remember like that. I can explain in alternative way. That's not enough. I have to explain big theory. Listen, if ripple will decrease, automatically ripple factor will increase. Okay, should try to reduce. Ripple decrease in the sense we are getting more uniform DC waveform in the output side. Okay, first of all, this is the first conclusion. In half-wave rectifier, if you observe the output waveform, we will have discontinuity. From 0 to 180, you will have the waveform. Again, from after 180, you don't have any waveform. Again, you will get, this is what? For a particular duration, I don't have any DC waveform. This is called a discontinuity. When I am going for full-wave rectifier, see there. Now I am getting continuous waveform. Of course, my waveform has been improved a lot from half-wave rectifier. So what is the conclusion here? When your number of pulse will increase, automatically ripple in the waveform will decrease, right? So next I can say it is also directly proportional to what? Number of pulse. So when your ripple will decrease, ripple decrease in the sense we are getting more uniform waveform, right? So number of pulse in increase, automatically ripple factor will increase, ripple decrease. So from this, what I can say? From this, I can say if you have more ripple, it means we have more harmonics. Ripple decreases in the sense harmonics will decrease. Getting me? That is the point where your ripple factor will increase. So while going from half-wave rectifier to full-wave rectifier, we are getting more number of pulse. It means we are getting more ripple factor and the ripple value will automatically decrease. It means harmonics compression. Harmonics will be reduced. So what is the conclusion? They are talking about ripple factor, right? While going from full-wave rectifier, from half-wave rectifier, automatically ripple factor will increase. It will be greater than half of the half-wave rectifier value, right? Of course, it will increase a lot. That's all. So this is the conclusion. Should try to make a note of it. These are all observations. There was no theory behind of it. You have to substitute and you have to check it. Fine. The next question is, one second, if the duty cycle of a DC chopper is alpha, if the duty cycle, we all know, right, duty cycle of a DC chopper is alpha, then what is the ripple factor? That's all. Same question, right? But ripple factor is given by. That is the question. Let me drop the options. Option A, 1 upon alpha. Option B, square root of alpha upon 1 minus alpha. Option C, alpha. Option D, square root of 1 minus alpha upon alpha. Yeah, that's all. Take your time and drop your answer. Do it fast. Option A, is that correct? Okay, your time is over, right? So let me try to solve. Listen. What is the formula to obtain the ripple factor? The formula to obtain the ripple factor is, let me write, fundamental voltage minus output voltage, total output voltage, divided by total output voltage square. We should keep them all under square root. This is the exact relation. Whereas we all know the total output voltage, which is equal to what? Alpha times of source voltage. This is exactly correct. Right? V naught. V naught is total or net output voltage. Whereas V naught 1 is fundamental output voltage. Fundamental means, or I can say output RMS voltage, right? Now you have to estimate the output RMS voltage. How will you estimate the output voltage? Output RMS voltage means just we have to take square root for your duty cycle and we should get the output. See, I'm not forcing you to memorize these things, right? How will you calculate the RMS? Just to go through your notes, take your output waveform, calculate the RMS voltage. What is the output for your chopper circuit? You will get the value from 0 to T on, right? This is going to be your source voltage. You will receive the output voltage from 0 to T on, and for the rest of time period you don't receive. That is, in the off time your value will be 0, right? Now I am requesting you to calculate the value of V naught RMS. How will you calculate the V naught RMS? To know the RMS value, root mean square value, that is the formula. Root mean, it means I have to take root for your mean value, right? So once again, while calculating the area for this function, right, what we need to do, just you have to consider this is going to be the width and this is going to be the height of your system, right? So while calculating root mean value, listen, first of all, keep all the values. Okay, wait, I don't have space here. Let me rub the options, right? Because you know the option, I don't want to know the option. Let me place it. Listen, in general, I'm just asking you, how will you calculate the RMS value for this cycle? I have 0, T on here, this is T off, or I can consider the total time period T. This duration is T off, I know that is 0 value. Here I have source voltage. Calculate the RMS value for the total cycle from 0 to T. How will you calculate? In short, let me directly write V naught RMS equal to, of course, if you want to consider the general procedure, you can consider. What is the general procedure? 1 by T, right? We have to travel from 0 to T, and with this what? We have to consider the total voltage square with respect to time period. And we should keep all these values under root. This is the formula, general formula. Now let me consider. 1 by T is the total time period. Whereas, let me break the interval into 2 off. 0 to on time. From 0 to T on, we have the voltage. Right? Yes. What is the voltage that we have? Vs square is the voltage that we have with respect to time period. Whereas in the second half, from T on to, I can say from T on to total time period, from on time to total time period, we have 0. We don't have any value with respect to dt. So this portion will be 0. Right? So let me remove this portion. We need fundamental RMS. That's what I'm doing now. Under root, according to general formula. Now we can take Vs square outside, such that it will become Vs outside, square root, so I am taking Vs square outside. And since we are doing integration with respect to time period, your voltage does not vary with respect to time since we have DC voltage. So DC voltage is constant, so that's why I am taking it outside, right? So in the square root, still we have 1 by T, this is 1 by T, and DT, integration of DT will become T, and the limits is 0 to T on. Exactly, that is correct. Now what is your answer? Vs into T on. Right, upper limit is T on, lower limit is 0. Of course, this is T on by T. Since all are lying under root, don't forget, all are lies under root. Now, please tell me, what is value of T on by T? That is alpha or delta, something, duty cycle. So, that is Vs into square root of delta. This is the RMS voltage, right? Now, just to substitute these two values into the equation, you'll get the answer. See, I'm repeating once again, you will never face new concept. Don't you know how to calculate RMS value? You know the procedure. In network, first chapter basic, we learn these things, right? So they never test you with some new concept. They will test your intelligence, how you are thinking. Anga learn panna concept, neenga eppadi apply pandringendra da inga question, right? So let's see. So ripple factor equal to V naught 1, that is fundamental, that can be replaced by square root of alpha into Vs whole square minus V naught.
alpha times of Vs, that is total voltage, in the denominator alpha times of Vs whole square. We should keep them all under root. Let's see. So first, square root of alpha whole square will become alpha dot Vs square minus alpha square Vs square. Am I correct? Alpha square Vs square divided by alpha square Vs square under root. Let us reduce. Let me write like this. Alpha times of Vs square divided by alpha square dot Vs square minus alpha square Vs square divided by alpha square Vs square. Shall we write like this? I'm just breaking the numerator such that one alpha is getting cancelled. This all factors are getting cancelled. Finally, we are going to get 1 by alpha minus 1 whole power 1 by 2. Or we can say, which is equal to 1 minus alpha by alpha whole power 1 by 2. That is the correct answer. I don't know which option it is. You just pick it. This is the answer. Yeah, I'm having the question right. That is option D. One second. Let me rub this one. Okay, listen. Actually, the question is, the three pulse converter has a freewheeling diode across its load. Has a freewheeling diode across its load. The operating range of the converter is dash. The operating range of the converter is dash. The operating range of the converter is dash. Operating range of the converter is dash. That's all. It's a kind of small question. Don't think too much and don't be bothered. You can get the answer. First, they said alpha. They are talking about firing angle actually, right? Option B, they said 60 degree to 180 or 120. 120. Option C, they said 30 to 150. Option D, 180 to 360. Answer, very small question, don't take too much time. Drop your answer, do it fast. Option C means 30 to 150, yeah, your time is over, listen, that's correct. See, what is the purpose of connecting freewheeling diode in order to neglect negative portion, right? Of course, in three pulse converter, what is the initial value? Alpha will be triggered. Alpha value 0 varumbodhu, what is the value of omega t? Omega t is 30 degree, right? Phase A will start its conduction at omega t equal to 30 degree. I hope, please revise your notes. I cannot go through all things here itself, right? So alpha, this is the initial point or for your triggering angle. this is the point where your alpha is start, and alpha start pandra point la what is LF omega t, that is 30 degree. Now from here you can go, this omega t can go up to 180 degree where your voltage is positive. If you go beyond 180 degree, voltage will become negative, right? And the next thing is alpha is 30 here, exactly at this point alpha is what, 150 degree. See, there is a difference between 30 degree, difference between alpha and omega t is 30 degree. If omega t is 180, automatically alpha will become 150 degree only, right? So alpha can go from 0 to 150, whereas from 30 degree to 180 voltage will be positive. If you go beyond 180, you will get negative voltage. Of course, there also you can allow the alpha to increase, but due to the connection of your freewheeling diode, they said they are connecting the freewheeling diode. Freewheeling diode never allowed to go up with a negative voltage. It will remove this portion. So I cannot go beyond 180. So the maximum value of omega t is, you can go up to 180, and the maximum value of alpha is 150 degree only. If there is no restriction, you can go with a negative value also. So what is the conclusion? Alpha lies in between 0 to 150, whereas omega t is lies in between 30 degree to 180 degree. That is the correct answer. Anyway, in our question, they are asking only alpha value, right? Alpha means 0 to 150. This is the correct answer. See, if you don't know this concept fully, you may have a doubt how to get this answer. For that, you have to little bit know the output waveforms of three-phase rectifiers. If you don't know, then I cannot explain these things. You just go through it. அதை நீங்கள் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக புதுசாக யாரெல்லாம் இப்போ இப்போ தான் பார்க்குறீங்களோ, நீங்கள் அதுக்கப்புறம் கான்செப்ட் பார்க்கும்போது உங்களுக்கு புரிஞ்சிடும் நான் ஏன் இங்கேருந்து ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுறேன் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு. இட்ஸ் வெரி சிம்பிள், டோன்ட் திங்க் டூ மச். கான்செப்டை கிளியராக அப்படியே லிசன் பண்ணிங்கனாலே ஐடியா வந்துடும். தட்ஸ் எனஃப். ஓகே, ஐ ஃபவுண்ட் தெர் ஆர் வெரி ஃபியூ மோர் க்வெஷ்சன்ஸ், பட் I would like to solve those questions by today evening, right? Probably rectify, that is power electronics are over. See, there was some questions from that, some semiconductor switches at all, but they are worthless. Just go through panina apdi answer pandra madha, very few questions are there from that area. Anyway, just to go through the concepts, that's enough. Okay, fine. So I said after completing the power electronics, immediately we are going to solve problems in our engineering mathematics as per the weightage I am going, right? So should try to go through the complete notes of matrices first, that's enough. Matrix motto full up paranga. Today by evening we will solve problems in matrix. Okay, with this let's wind up the class. Thank you all.